Their aim was to put an end to AM radio static. They wound up creating the FM band. After 9/11, radio stations, TV channels, and others set up shop at the tower when their broadcasting stations at the Twin Towers were destroyed. Sad to say, Armstrong committed suicide after a long path of litigation with RCA and others. This ate away his fortune. Palisades Amusement Park, located on the cliffs south of the George Washington Bridge, opened in 1898, and for 73 years, it was the most popular attraction on both sides of the Hudson River, a mecca for the young and the not so young. The park grew up as a trolley park, an end-of-the-line picnic road. It was created to drum up business on the weekend for the streetcars. It had more than 70 rides on its 40 acres. There was a cycle roller coaster, a tunnel bluff, and its famous saltwater pool, 400 feet wide and 600 feet long, complete with its own waves. In 1944, tragedy struck. A catastrophic fire on the Virginia Reel left 7 people dead and half the park in ruins. The park was never the same after the fire, and in 1971 it closed after 73 years of operation and bringing happiness to thousands. All one can see now are high-rise condominiums. The George Washington Bridge, crown jewel of the Hudson. If you have ever seen the bridge lit up at night with millions of little bright white lights, looking like a crystal bridge, you will know why I call it our crown jewel. When it is lighted, which is not very often, the bridge is one of the great beauties of our area. In 1981, on the bridge's 50th anniversary, the press was lavish with its headlines. Europe has its cathedrals, Egypt has its pyramids, but we have the George Washington Bridge. In 1927, the project's 3,500-foot span was the most ambitious and longest bridge-building effort at that time. No one considered that the bridge would eventually carry 14 lanes of traffic on two decks, except the chief engineer, Othmar J. Ammann. Ground was officially broken in October 1927. By May, dredges were at work removing 75,000 cubic yards of silt from the site for the piers of the New Jersey Tower. This was started first because of the large amount of excavation needed. Foundations extended as deep as 85 feet. Originally, the plan was to encase the towers in concrete and face them with granite after construction. But as an economy measure and the public's favorable response to the raw beauty of Ammann's steelwork, that idea was dropped, as was the proposed observation decks atop the towers. Only 6 of the 8 upper deck lanes were paved. That was sufficient until 1946, when the post-war boom in traffic necessitated the paving of the center lanes. Ammann was recalled to prepare for the construction of the lower deck in 1958. He had originally designed the bridge to carry either 4 train lanes or 6 road lanes on the lower deck. As the car became the dominant mode of transportation, the rail plans were abandoned. The lower deck opened in August of 1962. When work needed to be done, Ammann's plans always had the answer. There is a fact about the bridge that is truly remarkable. It was not only finished ahead of time, but at a cost that was $1 million under budget. That's something we don't hear these days. Its cost in 1931, including approach roads and land acquisition, was $59 million. But there were 13 casualties, and 3,447 men from all over the country were injured. Here I'd like to add a note about Ammann that I just learned about. He seems to have been the New York City's favorite bridge builder. In addition to the George Washington Bridge, he connected the city's boroughs with the Whitestone, Throgs-Neck, Triborough, Verrazano, and Williamsburg bridges. And for good measure, he built the Bear Mountain Bridge. I can't end without mentioning the Little Red Lighthouse. This was known to our children from the book of that name. The Coast Guard planned to leave it, but the clamor to save it was so great that they decided to keep it in its place under the tower. This ends my memories of the Palisades, the Hudson River, and the George Washington Bridge. In spite of LG, may they always be protected. Thank you for coming, and to my daughter Lori for her never-ending assistance. Thank you. Doris?
Recently, have you not spoken about some plans to destroy part of the Palisades, which is
yes,
that's a very big part.
I might have skipped that somehow. That's a very, very big part. Yes, I think you're paying up. Yes, I think I skipped until now. Yeah, LG, no, I said that. LG Electronics, South Korean company.
Right.
That was the one.
Yeah, was there more than that?
Well, I mentioned the critique in the Times and Rose Harvey and another view who was about the birds. So I think we covered that. Yes. John?
Thank you for those wonderful numbers. May I ask you one? Of my own.
Yes.
And that is of the excursion cruises of the Hudson River.
That's right.
Which went from the lower New York. Oh, I am as far as the trips thing. Thank you very much.
I know.
I should have remembered that because as a child I went on Bear Mountain steamer, or whatever they call it, the steamer up to Bear Mountain. And that was one of the things I've never forgotten, but this time I did forget. But it was great. We had a good day, and my cousin and I ran around the ship and had a good time. Yes, Pauline.
Edith, I don't have a question, but I just want to say I grew up at Palisades Park.
Did you really?
And I had many, many good memories.
I'm sure you did. And I'm sure you were very sorry when it disappeared.
Oh, very much so.
Yes. No, I think a lot of people in that area, and across the river, too. Yes.
I want to say something about Palisades.
Yes.
Park. I worked there. I did shows there. And I lived in Fort Lee for many years. And Mr. Rosenthal was a very special owner of the place. He was so spotless, he would walk and pick up cigarette butts so the place would be clean. And Palisades Amusement Park went out just as the drug trafficking came in. So it ended at a beautiful spot.
Right. Very good.
That was the end.
Maybe you'll have to give us a talk sometime on Palisade Park.
Pardon me?
Maybe you can give us a story sometime on Palisade Park.
There's a book on Palisade Park that I have.
Yes.
Edith, I live in Cliffside Park. We ended the school year with the whole town with a parade, and we marched through the whole town and ended up in Palisades Amusement Park, where our parents met us, and we each got a free strip of tickets, a strip of rides free to enjoy for the day, and that was everybody for the park, the residents of Cliffside Park.
It was a very people-oriented park.
That was more than 20 years, that they did that.
It's a shame. We miss those places.
Sure.
Well, I seem to have finished it for time. Ahead of time. I hope I didn't speak too fast. Sorry about that.
the whole thing on show?
I tried.
Yes, so that's nice to have, though. There'll be a record of it.
A few screw-ups, but...
Well, you had a little traffic coming in and out.
I know.
No matter what, you have a little traffic.
I'm sorry. I would have gotten them for you. Okay.
I know what place I was passing, and today they seem to just the direction of the other then just before the big
drop,
and there's a book right there.